your lips or when your chicken at the hop. Do the dance sensations that are sweeping the nation at the hop. Let's go to the hop. Let's go to the hop.
Oh baby,
let's go to the hop.
Oh baby,
let's go to the hop.
Come on,
let's go to the hop. Well, you can swing it, you can groove it, you can really start to move it at the hop. Where the jockey is the smoothest and the music is the coolest at the hop. All the cats and the chicks can get their kicks at the hop.
Really go for that Kirby Stone 4 with the If I Had a Dream Rock, real fine. As is our custom now on the Saturday Gay Ride, Gary Cocola's with us, a swinging sophomore from Fresno State. Hiya, Gary.
Just fine, Al. Be able to talk this week.
No laryngitis.
No laryngitis this week.
Well, we'll give you more time today then. I want you to introduce some of the newer things that you gave Fred Roberts to play, and every once in a while, don't forget to tell him what's underneath the letter A or the letter B.
Alrighty. We'll do that.
I can sort of rest up in the back seat here for my trip to Las Vegas. Without further ado, here's Gary Cocola now to introduce some of the things that could be big.
Fred Roberts, how about this one first of all? It's a new one by Little Sammy Yates. Go ahead with this one called Comic Book Crazy.
It's a bird.
It's a dog.
That's my baby.
Here I am in a lonely episode. I wonder why a man has to carry this load. It used to be the Western movie shooting up the land. There goes my baby in Superman's hand.
I'd just like to introduce myself. I'm Randall Cooper. I'm the Director of Parks, Recreation, and Community Services for the City of Fresno. And at all these groundbreakings we're having, I just always had the distinct pleasure of introducing my boss, the mayor of the City of Fresno, Alan Autry. It was his vision and dream to have these parks put in place to end the Tale of Two Cities. And I'm just fortunate enough to have a staff that allows us to develop these parks as fast as the mayor wants with the direction of the city manager. We are getting it done, and we're very proud of this park, and more importantly, we're proud of our mayor. So, Mayor Alan Autry.
Thanks, Randall. I tell you, it's, I'm not going to kid you. This job as mayor, job as a councilman, I can tell you, it's got its challenges. We knew that going in, but it also has its moments like this when it makes it all worthwhile, when you can do something that you know with a certainty enriches this community. You know, when you talk about a healthy community, starts rightfully so with public safety. We got to feel safe coming out of our homes and being able to live our lives, and we spend a lot of money. General funds all across this country and cities do that, and counties. Personal safety, very, very important, and we know that. Roads, critical, that you have good roads. There's a lot of things that they call basic infrastructure and basic needs to go into a healthy city. But without things like this, I don't believe you can have a healthy city. You need parks. You need a place for folks to gather. You need a place especially for kids to come together, especially in an urban environment. When you talk about basic infrastructure, and I know Sal Quintero, and I saw Sal going around and once said, you know, people are infrastructure. We can't forget that in the whole scheme of thing in policy making. People are what it's all about, and especially our children. And it's such a great feeling to come out here as part of this team. You know, mayors come, mayors go. Mayors die in office, mayors get recalled. They come and go. But the vision for a city can't. And that vision has to include our children, being taken care of our children, having make sure they get a quality education, they have a place to get out and have some fun. Away from those computers, very important. I'm not an anti-computer guy. It's the future, and every kid needs to be computer literate, but they also have to have their soul exercised and their heart exercised. And this is where you do it, out in places like this. And I'm just so happy that we have a fellow like Randall Cooper who has a heart the size of Montana and growing every day, leading this department, because we're just blessed as a community to have him. And I want to thank you, Randall, for you and your family for choosing Fresno. There was a lot of places he could go. He chose to come here. And finally, I would just like to, because I'm just happy. I'm not going to make some this is. I just sit back and just enjoy this things like this. And I look over to Al Radka, and I I tell you, anybody that lived in Fresno back in the 60s and 70s as a kid, I made a statement this week that was only, you know, I it was partially true. I said that if it wasn't for Al Radka, I may not have had a childhood at all. Now, that's not entirely true, but he was a big part of it. You know, Al Radka and the Three Stooges and the Lester Burger and old Bertie Olives and coming rushing home from school to be able to watch him. And I look at him, and Al was a very smart, smart man. Understood. I never met him personally, and it's one of my great regrets that I never got to sit down and talk with Al Radka. And I'll say this, three people that come to mind I wish I could have sat down and talked to. One was John Kennedy, the other was Ronald Reagan, and the third one was Al Radka. I mean that. To me, you sell them in the same breath, because I look at Al and I say, you know, that's the key. Al Radka, who he was, is the key to this city's survival, the state's survival, and this country's survival. It's not enough to appreciate your city, your state, your country. It's not enough to have affection for your city, your country. It's not enough to like your city. You got to love your city, because love spurs you to action. And Al loved Fresno. Love is the greatest motivator to get off your duff and do something for your country and your city and your state. Gary Cocola, I want to thank you, Gary, for, you know, you'll be up here speaking for that bust. The thing is, you love Fresno. Mike Dagis loves Fresno. Andy Souza loves Fresno. Randall Cooper likes San Jose, or used to be, but now he loves Fresno. So with that, I'd like to introduce a friend of mine, and I call him that first and foremost, because I'm heading out the door here, and I've come to love this individual. He's become a very, very close friend of mine at City Hall. I love to hear him cut through all the clutter and all the arguments, and everything just calms down when old Mike grabs that microphone, as he did yesterday, and said, you know, this is a great day. We got to turn a 25-year plan to a fire department into a 5-year plan. We're going to save lives. Got to tuck us some money away for the community. And we got to invest for the future. And I'd like to introduce you now, Mike Dagis. Mike, come on up here. God doesn't guarantee you your next breath that you're going to have. So hopefully we're going to have a lot more of these next 2 years. But if we don't, I want to say it now. I love you, man.
I love you too, Mayor. You look around the room, I am so humbled right now. I'm amongst so many legends in the city of Fresno. Way too many to name. And I'll tell you, I look out and I see Gus Zerniel over there. He's probably the baseball legend of Fresno. And I'm glad to see you here, Gus. But I want to thank Randy Cooper for having the vision for this park. And Jerry Haynes for applying for the grant with the state of California that enabled us to build the park. And I also want to thank Pete Rocco, Forrest Dean, and especially Heather Hanks for putting all this together. They're the people from our Parks and Recreation, our city of Fresno. And Mayor, I want to thank you, because unfortunately I read the obituary of Al Radka, and first thing I thought of was let's name this park after Al Radka. But I knew I couldn't get anywhere if I didn't have the mayor's blessing. I went up to Mayor Autry and I said, Mayor, this is what I'd like to do. I'd like to take before council and name this park after Al Radka. He looks at me and he goes, Mike, absolutely. He didn't hesitate. He didn't question. All he did was look at me and say, absolutely, that's the best thing we can do. And I want to thank you for that, Mayor. Thank you very, very much. And Cheryl Morrison from KJEO Channel 32. I want to thank you for all your work that you've put together today to make this happen. Without Cheryl Morrison and Heather, I don't think this could have been put together. So, Heather, thank you. And I also want to thank Gary Cocola. Gary, I want to thank you very, very much for donating this bus that will be unveiled here shortly. And all your work and effort. I'll tell you, Gary, we would not be standing here today if it wasn't for you, and I really appreciate that. Thank you very much. on your back of your program, there's a lot of sponsors that Gary got together, and I want to thank those sponsors. I'm not going to name and read each one, but please read the back. And I always say, when you read the back of it, make sure that's where you spend your money too. But I wanted to quote a little something from former Mayor Dan Whitehurst that I heard on the radio, and it is just the perfect saying for Al Radka. Al Radka loved Fresno and made it fun to be here. He was a sports guy and a Fresno State guy. He was everybody's favorite uncle, who wore goofy hats and hammered it up for the kids. He was part of our lives like Captain Kangaroo and Davy Crockett. Al was something Fresno had in common. He was a constant, like the summer heat and the winter fog. We all knew his jokes, and his sponsors became a household name as well. Lester Burger, Oberti Olive, Producers Dairy, Lemoore's Cleaners. If they were friends of Al's, they were friends of ours. And that is just so, so true. I remember the other, well, a couple of months ago when I brought this before council, I'm sitting up on the dais, and of course I need to convince council members to support my motion to name this park after Al Radka. And I said, you remember the jingle, Producers? P-R-O-D-U-C-E-R-S, Bell's Producers. I think we knew how to spell producers before we knew how to spell our own names. Go to kindergarten, we can spell producers. We couldn't do anything else. My wife calls me that afternoon and she goes, Mike, what are you doing? I said, I'm naming the park after Al Radka. She goes, no, KMJ has you singing on the radio. She said, Mike, keep your day job, quit the singing. But you remember Oberti Olive's? Only better eaters really taste it. Gentleman's up here, he's nodding his head. Absolutely. And you remember Lester Burger, Les Lindley, that owned Lester Burger? Lettuce. Who said that? I know. But Al would hold the hamburger. Remember that? He would hold the hamburger, and he'd say, what is this? No, 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 that's the tomato. Well, what is this? No, that's the meat. What is this? No, that's the bun. What is this? That's the lettuce. Let us eat it. And he would always take a bite. Remember that? I got C's in school, but I can remember everything Al Radka taught me. Yeah. What a legend. What a pleasure for me to have a park named after Al Radka. God bless him. I would like to introduce now Fresno's favorite weatherman, Angelo Stawas.
Thank you, folks. What a great tribute to Al today. It is so great to see all these wonderful faces from Al's past and my past. Gus Zernial over here, Lee Jason, our program director, and his lovely wife, Patty, and Beth Elliott, who's here. Don Elliott directed many of those shows that Mike was talking about. You know, Al just had a heart of gold and a tremendous love for this community and for the San Joaquin Valley. You know, the Hot Stove League, some of you remember that, I'm sure. How many years did that run? I don't even know, but he brought people to Fresno. John Wallace, who was our anchor man way back with me, he remembers what Al did, bringing these top stars from the major leagues to this community so that youngsters could see their faces, get their autographs, shake their hand, you know. That was Al, and he did have a tremendous a heart that was just wonderful. You know, he would make you laugh. And as John was talking about just a little while ago, Andy Kay, I see Andy Kay right there too, who worked with Al at KFRE Radio. Andy, you guys were in that mobile home together, weren't you? Wandering around the streets, talking on the radio. But Al's heart of gold was just the spirit that he carried into this community. that, as John was telling me a little while ago, when you became an employee at Channel 30, he welcomed you with open arms. You know, he was just a guy that made you feel so much at home. And I can remember my hands, I bet Lee Jason can remember this, my hands were trembling as a fledgling director. And if I screwed up a show and had to rewind a segment, Al would laugh. You know, he would smile. He wouldn't get angry. He would just say, ah, Stalas, you know, we'll get it right the next time, you know. And that was the way Al showed his friendship to all of us at Channel 30 and then, of course, in the community as well. But, you know, subtle things that I noticed as a director, and, of course, Don Elliott directed many of Al's shows. I did a few, but subtle things like toward the late 70s, early 80s, Al did 5 20-minute shows, no breaks within these 20-minute shows. They were public affairs programs. 5 in a row on a Wednesday afternoon, and the only break was in between the shows when he would take the guests out to the front lobby and bring in the new guests back to the studio. But, you know, occasionally he would get a guest who would only answer with a yes or a no answer. And God bless Al, you know, you could see the light go on. He would then go about and fill that 20 minutes with conversation and not make the guest feel ill at ease. He would make the guest feel more comfortable as those 20 minutes went on. And it was just a tremendous thing to see. That was his generosity. Rather than say, you know, we're going to stop this and start over, he would continue and maybe talk about the hot stove league for the last 10 minutes of the show. But that was Al. He was so fantastic. And if he wanted to thank you for something, if he wrote you a thank you note, it wasn't just a couple of lines on a piece of paper. It would be a couple of lines on a piece of paper, and then on the bottom and on the sides and on the top and on the back and a smiley face. And Al was just constantly doing that. And, you know, he would wake up in the middle of the night. I think I've heard people say that he would get his ideas for things like Producer's Dairy. Richard Chahati is back here, who thanks Al for that Mike Dages rendition of Producer's Dairy. But, you know, he would get his ideas for commercials in the middle of the night, write them down and come into the station and get everybody excited about something like that and get them done. And one of the last commercials I directed was an Oberti Olives commercial. He and Tommy Bond put together this big wheel that had maybe a couple of dozen Oberti Olives cans affixed to this wheel. You might remember this spot. And the wheel moved very slowly, and we superimposed Al in the middle of this wheel. And he had his nightcap on. Was it that nightcap? Maybe that one. And he just ended the spot. The last 10 seconds, he said, I'm just going to do this, and she says, I'm just going to go, oh, Oberti Olives. Oh, Oberti Olives. And the darn cans are going over the top of his head. You know, they just look beautiful. And that was our Al Radka. But, you know, I'm so proud to be here today. I'm so proud of Gary Cocola and Mike Dages and you folks for doing this in Al's name. And I'm sure Alma May, his wife, is too. But I'll leave you with this, is that when I was about, I guess I was about 14 years old, my brother and I were going through downtown Fresno. My brother was driving. And we came to a stop in front of the T.W. Patterson building, where Al used to be an announcer at the, you know, for KFRE radio. And we came to a stop, and Al stepped off the curb right there, looked into our car, and smiled that big Al Radka grin, you know, right at us, didn't know who we were, and raised those eyebrows a few times, fluttered those eyebrows. And that's really what I remember today. And, I have a little glimpse of what this is going to be, but it will always be that wonderful smile of Al Radka that will stick in my mind forever. Thank you, folks, for coming today. Let me introduce now the CEO, the president of Cocola Broadcasting, the guy who got this all done with Mike Dages, Gary Cocola, ladies and gentlemen.
Good morning. Thank you all so much for coming.
I was fortunate enough to have met Al Radka 50 years ago this last May 12th, 1956, for the very first time. On that day, KFRE Channel 12 signed on the air from 733 L Street in Fresno. I had been chosen by the principal of my high school, San Joaquin Memorial, to represent the school on a new television program called Al Radka's Open House. Each Wednesday, between 5:30 and 6 o'clock, I, along with other high school representatives, and hopefully one of the other representatives is here in the audience today, is Sandy DeLito Zinken here. She's in Palo Alto. Okay, well, Sandy and I were very, very fortunate to rate popular music. And this appearance evolved into a weekly television show on Channel 12 each Saturday called the TV Record Hop. And you can look back here, and there's the TV Record Hop with Al in the center of the record. It was due to Al's tutoring in the following years and my love for broadcasting that Al was really the most important part of getting me into the broadcasting business. I truly felt adopted by Al and Alma May. I felt like a son that they never had. And when I first received a phone call from Councilman Mike Dages' office, Sal Quintero said to me that the city of Fresno was going to name a park in Al's honor. And I told Sal that I very much wanted to be involved in that park. So creating a monument to honor Al and respect his memory is just a small part of my way to repay Al for all he did and all he has meant to me in my entire life. Getting a little emotional there. I had the privilege of participating in the induction of Al into the Clovis Chamber Hall of Fame 3 years ago. And actually, that's how I met my new bride, as she was in charge of collecting memorabilia for him. And I always tell Juliana, Al brought us together. So today is a privilege of the highest order to participate with the City of Fresno's grand opening and dedication ceremony. It's a profound joy to present this bust of Al so that all who will visit this park in the many years ahead can enjoy an outing here and read the inscription and know who he was. I'd like to invite Al's niece and nephew, John Goss and Janie Goss, up with my wife Juliana to unveil the bust of Al Radka. You guys want to pull together?
Ready? Should we get front?
Yeah. And there he is. On one of the handouts that you'll see today, there's a story of the young man who was involved in creating this bust, Bernard Hare. And I also want to thank Mike Murphy, who shepherded this all the way through from its inception to reality. Mike, thank you. A local artist, Mike Murphy, thank you. I also want to thank you, Mayor Autry, Councilman Dages, Parks and Recreation Director for the City of Fresno, Randall Cooper. Thank you, Randall. And, of course, my pal here and buddy, Angelo Stalas. And I think there's, I don't really think there's a rivalry, but is Kopi still here? I mean, you know, come on. You guys really did take Al's place in this market, okay? You are now the new Al Radkas. I also want to thank Paragon Marble for the marvelous job that they did on this beautiful podium. We have had tremendous support, and we wish to thank the community for their generous donation to this day's event. And I think Angelo mentioned, or someone mentioned, all of the folks who were here, and some of my old friends, Eli and Andy Kay and Colin Doherty. Thank you all so much for coming today.
I'd like to also thank Cheryl Morrison from our staff and to Heather Hanks for their untiring work in putting today's event together. We're going to close now by inviting you to a continental breakfast and a reception immediately behind us. So thank you again on behalf of the Al Radka family and Alma May. God bless Al.
Well, let's get back to the TV record hop like we used to have on this station about 25 years ago that we used to host ourselves right here. I used to do a show something like this. I didn't have all these fancy record players and everything. But Gary Cocola and Marlene Cocola, they were helping us in those days. And I hope they're watching this morning. Gary and Marlene were a big help to us. But now it's back to the amazing Les Mays.
And here we go. Are we ready for it, ladies and gentlemen? Boys and girls, wake up this morning. Dealing with the invisible man's band.
All right, our 1988 TV Record Hop continues. We've got a special guest today, and here they are.
You know it, Angelo, old buddy. We're going to have the zoo lady out here in just a moment, Linda McAlexander, the world's greatest zoo lady. But here's one of the coolest cats in the whole wide world who came down for the dance party again today. His name is Dynamite Dan. Good morning, Dynamite. How do you feel?
Scooby-Doo.
Are you enjoying all this dancing this morning?
I am grooving, you know. Is that in? Grooving?
Yeah, that's
anyway,
in.
You I love it.
You look cool.
Cool.
And neat.
Scooby-Doo.
Hey, I tell you what, good friend, how about a health tip for all the boys and girls watching in this Saturday morning?
Well, you know, one of my favorite pastimes besides get down discoing...
What's that, buddy?
...is to go bicycle riding.
Me, too.
Hey, and I should suggest that boys and girls be careful on their bicycles. Watch out for cars.
At all times.
They're bigger than you, and if they should, get involved in an accident... Oh, boy. So be careful. Ride your bikes with care. Do not disco on your bicycles. Scooby-Doo.
That's good advice, Dynamite.
I love the TV record hop, okay. 1980 style.
Tell you what, if I find you a partner, would you get out there and dance the next number?
Are you serious?
You're ready, aren't you?
Can I have the cute one over there?
You
or the
sure
cute one
can.
Over there?
I'll get it all lined up for you.
Scooby-Doo.
Thanks a lot, Dynamite Dan. Right behind this set here, I have the one and only Les Mays. Good morning again to you.
Well, good morning to you, Al.
You know, I have great admiration for you. You know that, don't you? You're one of the most successful young men, I say young advisedly, because you told me to say that. But right here in the Valley, you are busy all the time doing things. People love you, and I do too. And if you'd like to use Les Mays and his disco equipment at a big dance or something, just give him a ring. He's in the book, Les Mays. What is your number, by the way? Well, they could always call me here at the station, couldn't they? Huh? Sure. Hey, sensational, Les. I can't thank you enough for the great show you gave us today. Wasn't that great, Butch and Linda,
great
huh?
Great show. Beautiful.
And to think it all started with this old album that we happened to keep. 25 years ago, this same channel had a program called the Saturday TV Record Hop, hosted by Old Al and the Cocolas, Gary and Marlene. And I hope they remember this album, and I sure want to thank Les Mays and all these beautiful boy and girl dancers here today. Wasn't it great, Butch?
Beautiful show. Really great show.
Terrific.
And I think we have a little time left with my old theme. Why don't we get out and sort of dance off the program here, huh? And don't forget, we'll have them on the show every once in a while. Mind your folks, be careful crossing streets, and stay away from the canals. They are for irrigating, not for swimming. And we'll see you next Saturday on the Saturday Children's Showcase. Yeah!